You're watching Dixie RV's Tigers versus Tide coverage on WDSU News This Morning.
Good morning and welcome to Baton Rouge, where later this evening, number 5 LSU will take on number 1 Alabama in a duel in Death Valley. I'm LaTanya Norton here with WDSU sports anchors Chris Miles and, of course, Fletcher Mackel. And the Tigers and the Tide are set to face off for the first time since LSU lost in the national championship game.
Ooh, that was an ugly game, LaTanya. That's right. The Tigers are hoping for different results. Back in January, Alabama quarterback A.J. McCarron tossed for 234 yards, in that 21-0 victory.
Yeah, it really was a coming of age for him, and the Tigers got just 53 yards from their starting quarterback, Jordan Jefferson. McCarron will be back on the field tonight, but Zach Mettenberger is now the starting quarterback for LSU. He has struggled a bit in his first year at the helm with just 7 touchdowns and 4 interceptions. Only one of those touchdowns have come in 3 SEC games. Alabama also has the top-ranked defense in the country. Mettenberger says, don't expect the Tigers' passing game to be passive tonight.
It's like, you know, LeBron James will go out there and shoot 40 baskets in a game. But if he shoots 10 and gets to 8 points, I mean, you know, you can't score if you don't shoot. I mean, that's what I'm trying to say. And, you know, you can't hit those big, deep balls if you don't throw them. And, you know, it's definitely exciting to see that the coaches were able to call my number.
Good Saturday morning. We are live in Baton Rouge, and guys, as you know, there are thousands of LSU fans all across Louisiana, but there's one who takes being a Tiger fan to a whole new level.
That's right, and his love for LSU is hard to miss in Metairie. WDSU anchor Randy Russo introduces us to the man known simply as Big Lee and tells us how his obsession began.
Many Tiger fans say they bleed purple and gold.
LSU, LSU, LSU.
But one fan takes his love of LSU to a whole new level.
Come on, Alabama, we're going to get you, boy.
Meet Big Lee. While not everyone may recognize his face,
Big Lee, can I help you?
You can't miss his home. On this bustling stretch of Bonneville Boulevard, Big Lee's house is a shrine to LSU.
I love purple and gold. I bleed it. I live it. Every day I go by, I live with purple and gold, you know.
And it doesn't stop with the exterior. Inside, nearly every inch of his walls are covered in LSU posters, art, shirts, even an LSU pool table and entertainment room. But Big Lee's most prized possession, his fleet of trucks.
I love my LSU truck. I love my tow trucks. And everything I own is like purple and gold.
Big Lee's obsession started years ago with just a few hats on the wall. But after dating an LSU cheerleader, his passion for the team grew. Today, he can't count the amount of money he spent on the team's paraphernalia and says there's always room for more.
If it's LSU and it's a little puppy dog or a cat with purple and gold, I buy it. If it says LSU on it, I buy it.
Sometimes he even makes his own. These two lions were hand-painted by Big Lee himself to welcome fans to his Tiger Cave. Actually, the only cats not purple and gold in this house are these two guys, Dominic and Harry Lee. Even Big Lee won't be seen without his LSU gear on.
Yeah, pretty much I wear LSU clothes every day. Not the same clothes, but I wear LSU. If I see pants I like these pants here, I bought like 6 of them at a time, you know.
On game day, Big Lee will be sporting his best Tiger stripes, predicting a big win over Alabama.
We'll see what LSU brings to the table, and then we'll go from there. But in my honest opinion, I'm thinking that we're going to pull it off with a field goal.
But win or lose, nothing is going to stop his Tiger spirit or keep his true colors from shining through. On your side, I'm Randy Russo, WDSU News.
Way to go, Big Lee. And just in case you're wondering, Big Lee is a bachelor.
Right.
Imagine
I don't know.
That.
I bet the ladies out there are very interested in meeting Big Lee.
He may not be a bachelor for long.
Yeah, well, another guy that's, well, Fletcher, you know this, may be a bachelor, maybe not, right? Your twin brother, Travers Mackel. Well, he sat down with LSU reporter from the Advocate New Orleans edition to get his take on tonight's game.
I'm Travers Mackle, joined by Les East with the Baton Rouge Advocate. We're going to jump right to it. LSU's offense, very sluggish all season. It's a topic that you've touched on repeatedly this season. Do they have to come out and show a better performance for this game against Alabama?
Well, yeah, I think so. You know, the big topic ever since the championship game last year was, can LSU throw the ball better and be more balanced on offense? And clearly they haven't been able to do that any better than they did last year. If they don't do it any better tonight, it's going to be a lot like January 9th. So they have to find a way to balance the run with the pass.
Check of your tailgating exact cast with meteorologist Damon. Damon, a big difference compared to earlier. Fog, not a big problem for us right now.
Yeah, it's getting much better, LaTanya. And where you are, the fog has definitely dissipated quite a bit. Other parts of Baton Rouge are experiencing some of the same low visibility that many parts of southeast Louisiana are experiencing right now.
Hi, everybody. I'm Scott Walker. We're joined now by NFL draft expert Mike Dettillier. And Mike, tell us about the crazy number of players in that could end up being first-round selections in next April's NFL draft.
Well, it's almost like an all-star game. In my projections, 14 out of the top 59 players are going to be playing tonight in Tiger Stadium.
And only a select few know what it's like to play in a big game like this one.
Well, certainly a guy that knows a thing or two about that, the exuberant former LSU center T-Bob Hebert, who has a unique perspective on the intense rivalry. Here's WDSU anchor Norman Robinson with him.
We're joined by T-Bob Hebert, former LSU Tigers center and son of former Saints quarterback Bobby Hebert. T-Bob, last year you were playing in this game. Tell us what the atmosphere between Alabama and LSU is like on the gridiron.
It's one of those things. I get goosebumps just thinking about it or talking about it. It's electric. It's really hard to put into words. I guess the closest thing that I could think of where I always went in my head was I went tried to go back to medieval times and the Coliseum and stuff like that, because it just, I don't know, it gets me excited playing in front of everybody.
That sounds very serious, like gladiators going at it.
Yeah, no, and that's, I don't know why. I may be weird, but that's how I always approached it. When I'd be putting on my pads, I treated each piece like a piece of my armor, and then when the face paint came on, that was when it was time to go to war.
And you had a soundtrack going in your head while you were doing all this?
Yeah, I listened to a lot of Led Zeppelin for the games.
You were pumped by the time the game started. Yeah, you were listening to Led Zeppelin.
Yeah, and then when you had 90-whatever-thousand people just cheering their hearts out to that, and a whole state really, and these are why you go to LSU and Alabama, why you go to these schools, are for games like this, where the whole nation is watching you. Everybody in the country is going to be watching this game.
No question, it's a big rivalry, one of the biggest in college football. Many say that this Alabama team is better than last year's team that won the national championship. Do you think that's true? And if so, why?
I think statistically right now, this team's absolutely incredible. I mean, you read in every facet of the game this year, this team has been, you know, just, they've been pretty close to perfect. But the issue is, because that they're chasing that perfection, I think they're stressed. I think they're not willing to make a mistake. And we are, make no mistake about it, LSU is the best team Alabama's faced this year. They haven't had a tough schedule up until this point. You look, Michigan was ranked number 8 for the season, not ranked anymore. Arkansas, ranked high at the beginning of the season, not ranked anymore. So they really haven't played anybody, and they're having to come into Death Valley, take all those perfect stats and everything into Death Valley against these Tigers. It's going to be tough for both teams. But this is one of those games where stats, you can kind of just throw it out the window.
In case you didn't know, one of the most popular bands in New Orleans has its roots right here in Baton Rouge.
You're listening to the Bucktown All-Stars. They play more than 100 gigs each year in New Orleans. But one of the founding members also has a deep connection to the Golden Band from Tigerland. WDSU anchor Randy Russo has his story.
If you've ever been in the stands and you hear Tiger Band strike up pregame, it sends chills down everyone's back and shoulders and everything, and it does to be in the band.
20 20 years ago, while a freshman at LSU, Ryan Thibodeau joined two groups that would change his life forever. The Bucktown All-Stars and the Golden Band from Tigerland. Thibodeau jokingly refers to his time with Tiger Band as the Dark Ages, when the football team wasn't doing that well and the focus turned to the musicians.
So when we would travel to road games and bus in, we would get off the bus to mobs of people. So it was just a really special experience for us to know that you were part of something that special.
Something else this trumpeter took with him from LSU, his degree in dentistry. At his practice in Metairie, he's found a way to marry music and teeth cleaning. So by day, he works in your mouth, and by night, he's music to your ears.
When I started to recognize that patients were really interested in talking about that other side of my life, really interested, more so than talking about their teeth, they wanted to know where I was playing next and what cool things I'd just done.
This all-star plays at more than 100 gigs a year, but there's one event that plays right to his Tiger spirit, the annual Tiger Band Alumni Game.
I was never able to experience that because my schedule with Bucktown and my day schedule doesn't allow me to give an entire day to rehearsal.
So he decided to organize one of his own. 4 years ago, on the night of the BCS game against Ohio State, Thibodeau sounded the call for former band members to reunite, and their response resonated through the French Quarter.
And I'd instructed everyone to assemble behind the stage, and I walked off stage and turned to my right, and there was about 75 musicians waiting there with their instruments, and I was expecting 5 to 7. And we had 75, and I was like, whoa.
Because it attracted such a following, Thibodeau has turned this reunion into an annual event. But this time, instead of New Orleans, he's moving the performance to Tiger Band's home turf, marching the traditional band route on LSU's campus.
Of course, we're going to welcome people to be with us. Former Golden Girls have committed to come and dance with us. Former Flag Girls are going to come out and bring their flags.
Thibodeau expects hundreds of former band members to take part prior to the Bama game. He says it's his way of paying homage to the school and the organization that gave him so much.
To know that you helped create that experience and you were part of that, being that catalyst to that energy, it's just a really, really neat thing, and it never goes away.
On your side, I'm Randy Russo, WDSU News.
A fall Saturday afternoon, Death Valley in Baton Rouge. The huge crowd, the Golden Band from Tigerland, and about 10 million goosebumps. Excitement, expectation. Well, what if you're only 5 years old and your lifelong dream has been to lead the Tiger Band on this historic walk? And what if that dream came true?
The band director saw a picture of Oliver in his uniform and wanted to know about his story.
Little Oliver certainly has a story. Born with spina bifida and an ever-present smile, this young Tiger fan already has been through a lot.
He is a little fighter. Everything that's been thrown at him, he's had major surgeries. He's only 5 years old, had multiple surgeries. But he's fought through every single one of them, and he's had the greatest attitude. And as a dad, I have learned from my five-year-old son.
So impressed was LSU band director Roy King with Oliver's story. He set about making that dream come true.
When we got the phone call over the summer and I told him, his little face just lit up. And literally, it was almost like Christmas morning every day. Mom, is today the day? No, baby. Is today the day? Not yet, baby.
Well, that day finally came as LSU took on South Carolina. And right in the middle of it all, leading the Golden Band from Tigerland, five-year-old trumpet player Oliver Pratts. The spectacle is exciting enough the way we see it. But check it out through Oliver's eyes.
We had a little head cam on Oliver's wheelchair, and we turned it around so that he could see what he was leading. And wow, it was overwhelming, starting with the drum major and the Golden Girls and the color guard and then the band right behind him. It was great.
It's great to have a day about him and for him. And just as a mom and my husband and I, it just brought us so much joy. Just the whole day, it was magical. It was like a Disney World day. It was magical.
Like the biggest thing I ever saw.
in your whole life?
Yes.
Is that smile going to stay on your face like forever?
Yes.
You can only imagine what must have been going through Oliver's mind, rolling through the enormous crowd. Not just cheering the football team, were they, or the band, but cheering him.
A million.
Are you sure?
Yes.
You sure? And they're your buddies, man. They were all your friends.
Yes.
And oh, what a night in Tiger Stadium. Seats right by the band, nobody's horn blew brighter than Oliver Pratt's. A battle hymn that propelled the Tigers to a much-needed victory. And boy, was it loud.
Yeah, how loud was it?
Like, really, really loud.
Oh, yeah, did it hurt your ears?
Yes.
It turned them green because your ears are still green from that day.
I know.
It was a literal dream come true for Oliver. And so that band, you know, we've sent them thank you notes, and we're going to forever support that band. But I don't think that they fully realize the extent to which they've blessed us and our family.
Oliver's a lifetime member of the Golden Band from Tigerland now, and he'll be back for LSU-Bama. All right, let me ask you this question. LSU's playing Alabama, right?
Yes.
Who is going to win?
Me.
And you can put that W in the books. On your side, Heath Allen, WDSU News.
You're watching Dixie RV's Tigers versus Tide coverage on WDSU News this morning.
And welcome back to Baton Rouge. I'm LaTanya Norton here with my distinguished colleagues, Fletcher Mackle, and of course, Chris Miles. All right, guys, it's time for the fun part. It's time for our rapid fire segment, the 2-minute drill. Now, we have a series of questions. Gentlemen, I'm asking you to please keep your answers brief. And the time is on the clock right now, so let's go. Who will have more rushing yards in this game, the Tigers or the Crimson Tide? Fletcher.
I say the LSU Tigers. Their running game has been tremendous. Jeremy Hill has been awesome. He's a freshman, but he's been very good. The one thing LSU has been able to do all season is run the ball. LSU's ground game is tremendous. Excuse me, Alabama's ground game also tremendous, but I say LSU.
I'm going to go LSU as well. Just look at the fact that they have 5 different guys that average close to 6 yards per carry or more. I think that that is the distinguished advantage that LSU has in this game.
All right, which quarterback will have a bigger factor, Alabama's A.J. McCarron or LSU's Zach Mettenberger, Chris?
I'm going to go Zach Mettenberger simply because whether he turns the ball over or has a big breakout game, I think he's going to be the X factor in this game. We know what A.J. McCarron can do and does. He has 18 touchdowns, no interceptions so far this season. Zach Mettenberger, just 7 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. He needs to have a breakout game. I think that he's the guy that's the X factor in this game.
I say A.J. McCarron. A.J. McCarron, the stats that Chris just said, 18 touchdowns, no interceptions. He's got tremendous talent around him, but when you watch the passes he throws, he has tremendous accuracy and great touches. He's completing about 75% of his passes, so he's very accurate. So I really believe that A.J. McCarron will have a bigger game than Zach Mettenberger.
And as you both know, both of these defenses are top-notch. Which defense will force more turnovers and lead to more points?
Let's hope it's LSU, because if it's not LSU, the Tigers can't win this game. LSU needs their defense to continue to play big. Their defense, they have 2 of the best defensive ends in the country, and Kiki Mingo and Sam Montgomery, both first-round draft picks. If those guys can pressure McCarron and force a turnover, they have a very good chance to win this game.
Chris?
I'm going to give you one simple stat on that. Alabama, and that's because they forced 23 turnovers so far this year, and that's led to 125 points. So I'm going to go Alabama in that category.
All right, here's the big question. What will be the final score of this game? Will it be like last year's regular season 9-6 overtime game with no touchdowns, or more like the 20-0 national championship game, Fletcher?
I don't think we're going to see a 35-42 shootout or a 42-35 shootout. I think it's going to be more like 17-10, and I do like the Tigers in this game.
I actually have to go with Fletcher as well. I don't think you'll see that 9-6 game like last year or 21-0 national championship repeat. I think it'll be somewhere in the middle.
All right, we're going to see what happens. You guys actually agree on a whole lot. All right. Thank you. We'll be right back. Stick around.
I'm here with Brian Ali Walsh, John Forkay with WGSO 990 AM, talking about LSU Tigers right now. Of course, you know, John, former Saints quarterback, Brian, longtime sports journalist. Does Mettenberger need to play the game of his life tonight in order to win against Bama?
Randy, not the game of his life, but in the past or in the earlier in the season, he hasn't been asked to win a game. He may be asked to win a game tonight.
And I believe that not just him, I believe the coaching staff at LSU. What I mean by that is that they have to put this young man in position to play good. Not ask him at the end of the game, go out and win the football game. Throughout the whole game, this coaching staff has to play call better than it has in the past.
You know what I think they need to do, John, and we've talked about this at length after the national championship game in which their offense just looked bland, stale, unimaginative. Their offensive coaches are going to have to come out with things like, why not throw on first down like Alabama did against them in the national championship game? You got to switch things up. Why not present a Wildcat offense package when they get in the red zone? You've got to get off the script if you're going to beat Bama, even if it's in Death Valley.
You're watching Dixie RV's Tigers versus Tide coverage on WDSU News this morning.
And welcome to Baton Rouge, where later tonight there will be a duel in Death Valley. Number 5 LSU takes on number 1 Alabama, and we are live to get you ready for the big game. Good morning, I'm LaTanya Norton, and I'm alongside WDSU sports anchors Fletcher Mackel and Chris Miles, and you can feel the excitement in the air, even though kickoff is still several hours away.
As is par for the course in Death Valley, the LSU defense has been stout this year, but stout won't be good enough tonight against Alabama. They need to be amazing. And by amazing, the Tigers need to force some turnovers.
So far this year, though, Chris, it's the Crimson Tide who seem to be like the Tigers from a year ago, turning turnovers into points. Last year, LSU forced 27 turnovers, which led to 15 touchdowns and 3 field goals. This year, Alabama has forced 23 turnovers, which has led to 125 points. A.J. McCarron has not thrown an interception this year, but the Tigers are hoping to become the first team to pick him off.
You know, that would be great. That's easy points for us if you're able to score on defense, you know. So if we can force a turnover, somebody can scoop it up and score, that would be amazing. But, you know, that's not something that you intend on seeing Alabama do. But if you can, then great.